night has fallen here at the Band Shell in Fair Park, which can only mean one thing. We're inching closer to our main event of the evening, Alex Del Bosque defending his ABO lightweight title against Daryl Hayes. But first, we have one more fight on what has been a great night of boxing here on 12 Rounds TV. This was the scene earlier in the locker room of Christian Faz, the current ABO super featherweight title holder, as he prepares to face battle-tested Guadalupe Perez in what should be another entertaining fight. There is a live look at Guadalupe Perez as he makes his way into the Band Shell. Time now for the tale of the tape, brought to you by Montoya Boxing Gym. Again, another great matchup on paper. Tonight's matchmakers have done a really good job at getting us some fantastic fights. None of them have disappointed. And there is the current ABO super featherweight champ, Christian Faz, belt proudly on display. The three judges for this co-main event tonight are Robert Chapa, Richard Lord, and Aladdin Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, time for our fourth bout of the evening. Third man in the ring, again, is Ruben Perez. Introducing first in the blue corner, he hails from Dallas, Texas, wearing the black trunks, weighing 131 pounds. It is Guadalupe Perez. And his opponent in the red corner, he hails from Dallas, Texas. He's wearing the blue trunks with the white trim, weighing 130 pounds. It is Christian Faz. Four rounds of action.
And once again, we send it down to the guys calling the action, Abel Guillen and Michael Montoya.
Guadalupe Perez in the all black. Christian has the blue shorts, white trim, or actually the white waist. There looks to be some type of TDLR holdup at this second. I think we're okay.
All right, let's rumble, baby. We're here.
I think we're okay.
Let's go. Let's see what Christian Faz has. This Guadalupe kid, he's got over 23 fights.
Yeah, he's leading off. Some jabs, one twos, combinations.
Let's see if he's here for a paycheck.
We'll find out. He's throwing some the right hook to the body.
Nice little jab.
Looks like Faz is just kind of just trying to get his legs here at this moment.
Come on, look at Faz. Faz has got a punch.
Yeah, he's got a punch. He's getting hit with some good shots. Perez is getting that work in at this moment, you know. Yep, right to the body, right to the body by Perez.
No.
Look, Faz is going to have to throw some punches. You don't want to eat too many of those, especially at the beginning of a fight.
You notice he just turned southpaw. Let's see if he stays southpaw.
Looks like Perez's trainers are liking what's happening so far.
Yeah.
Right now it's just all about punches.
Faz
starts throwing.
Nice left hook. And now Faz is turning back to an orthodox boxer.
Orthodox, yep. Yep, landed just like a short left. Oh, and then like a three-punch combination. It looked real nice.
Right hand.
Left.
Oh, nice right hand.
Well, looks like Foz is ready to stand his ground now and start coming forward.
Yeah, let's just get the, let's just go the distance, baby.
Yeah, yeah. Let's just get
we gotta
let's
go
get
four rounds
in. Let's get these rounds in. Yeah. Just nonstop action.
Oh, nice right hand.
Yeah, nice right hand over the top of the head. Foz looks to be a little phased by
I've
that.
Never been a fan of anyone switching unless you're the very
unless
few
you
Floyd
be
Mayweather.
Fighter, you have to be like in the elite levels.
Exactly.
Because it opens you up. There's right. just a lot of holes. And you know, if you're not comfortable in that position, it leaves you open for a big shot.
Terrence Crawford is one of those.
Oh, but he's on a elite right. levels. Elite levels. He can switch, and it doesn't even look like there's any difference in the left or
local sensation, Ray Jimenez. He fights left and right.
He's comfortable with both sides.
But even the greatest, Ali, he fought one way.
One way.
And my father,
it.
When I fought, we learned one way, baby.
Yeah.
Either fight right hand or
southpaw.
You're
trying to show off. You're trying to show that second way. And if you show any weakness that second way, get back to the other way. You know, that's the way that is.
I tell people all the time in the gym, why would you want to fight both ways if you can't even perfect as a right hand or
right
a lefty?
Yeah. If you have holes right handed, why are you going to turn left?
Exactly.
Like it just leaves you more open for. Just like that shot that's going to just turn your lights out. Ah, it looks like Pettis has slowed down a little bit, and Foz is right in front of him.
Still,
it's turned into like a really good fight. Yep, the strong look,
and Foz
then Foz is getting on
working,
coming forward. Yeah, out there in the center of the ring now, like Pettis is back to the ropes. It looks like he got tired a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
He's grinding now, his mouth's open. You can see his mouthpiece. But Foz is still right here in the front. Oh, landed some good shots, about 3-4 punches to the body.
Oh, nice left
good shot. Like, I think Foz woke up. But Pettis is not going down easily. That was a good round. That was a really good, that was an action-packed round.
One down and three to go.
Yeah. We'll see.
Remember,
we'll
see four's the magic number.
Four's the magic number. Let's go to the 12-round TV replay tracker with Grant Kaufman. Grant?
I thought it was a pretty even first round. Both guys landing a lot of solid punches. Great observation, Michael Montoya, with Foz switching to southpaw. Not sure what was gained by the move, but it's certainly something to keep an eye on as the fight moves forward. And guys, how about Baldo Delboski, Alex's dad, who's been working in nearly every fight tonight. This time he's with Guadalupe Perez.
Talk about wearing all hats. You know, Alex Delboski's father was like wrapping I don't know how many people's hands. He's been running around, I wouldn't say as much as you have, but he's been running out a lot. You know, obviously he's had multiple
You see his other trainer in the corner with him.
Oh, yeah.
Father Robin Marukin.
Yes, we were talking about Marukin earlier. Had that hell of a fight against Rigondeaux, you know, which I thought that, you know,
he had a great career with Top Rank. I told his father the other day, he's got nothing to be ashamed of.
No, not at all.
Move on. He's got an education. He's young. Yes. Got a family. Good job, career. Yep. Hey, boxing's a thing of the past. Move on.
Yep.
And the father said it to me two or three times. My son should retire. Maybe one more fight.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Back in action, round two here at the...
Exchanging jabs. Some pretty good stiff jabs. Pettis is still working.
I
give it to him. I thought he was tiring, but no, he's in there.
One, two.
I would say Foz is going to have to pick up the action. Yeah. He's going to have to... I will say he's cornering. He's cutting off the ring well. That was a good left.
Nice left hook.
Right, Foz with
nice
that uppercut.
Yep.
Yeah, but Pettis is just right in front of him, landing shots right down the pike, right on that center line. He's just staying there.
Oh,
see, right hand to Pettis. Another right hand, left hand to the body.
Nice left hook, right uppercut.
Combination by Foz. Pettis is just trying to stick his head in his chest and then to a right hand. Oh, and then Foz is just coming forward.
He's tough.
Yeah, he's definitely tough. Foz is landing some really good shots.
Guy's throwing everything but the kitchen sink.
Everything. Hey, but like Foz is standing right there. It doesn't look like he's been like hurt badly or by anything. We're trying to just wear down Pettis.
What do you think these guys are weighing today, day of the fight? They weighed in at 130.
Yeah, I'm probably thinking like 150 ranges, 140s, like high 140s. But you never know. You know, like that's always a big thing with Canelo. People are always mad. Oh, he comes in 30 pounds over and all these types of things. So they don't look weight drained at all. I'll give you that. You know, like they look like ready. They look ready. Yeah, again, you know,
nice shot to the body.
Yeah, Foz is really good at cutting off the ring. You know, Pettis
is.
Hey, that nice little hook of the right hand there, that was pretty nice to like stop.
But
the
again,
action
I still don't like that he continues to fight southpaw and then switches to right.
Yeah.
There he goes.
If anything, he just wants to. He's going to have to start landing punches. You don't want to lose rounds against a grinder like Pettis looks like. He's just going to try to grind these rounds out. and take it to four rounds like we were talking about. Yeah, see that left? That's a good shot by Foss.
What do you think? Toss-up?
Toss-up at this point. Toss-up at this point. Because
Foss is turning it on.
See, Foss is turning it on right here late.
This kid's tough.
He's definitely tough. And then Foss looks focused. He's coming in left.
Nice right.
Stiff, yeah, left. There's the combination.
Oh, nice body shot. Right hand to the body. Nice body shot. But there he is. He's a southpaw again.
Yeah, he's southpaw again. Letting good shots, but it doesn't look to be like hurting Pettis. It's probably, there he goes right-handed. You know, just landing those, like, touch shots. Pettis looks tired. He's breathing heavy.
Guy's a warrior.
Yeah, he's definitely. He's not going anywhere. He's just breathing him up.
Oh, nice combination.
Shots. In the final 10 seconds. Yep. Yeah. I think he got saved by the bell there at that point.
We might have a 1-1 split at this point.
Yeah, we could. Yeah, we definitely should. Honestly, I see it. I see it like that. 1-1 going into the third. You see Pettis kind of, that cardio is kind of catching up to him. And Foss looks to have saved that energy. He doesn't look like he's breathing hard at all.
Right.
His trainer's talking to him. Usually, like, you see a little bit of fear whenever, like, that when your cardio is going and you get tired. I can't lift my arms anymore, so. We'll see if Pettis can keep up this.
What do you think about the crowd?
Oh, that's great. You can hear them. They're loving the action.
Beautiful.
The DJ's awesome. You know, the DJ plus the action is keeping everybody involved.
We got some contenders.
And the ring girls are.
I'm still
solid.
Not a fan of having round one. I've never seen.
I
that
know.
Before.
Me either. Me either. We talked about that. I don't. I no. I don't.
You look at every fight, every legit fight. I'm just saying.
Yeah. Like I'm a firm believer in introducing the fighters when they're in the ring, right. Not when they're walking.
Right.
And I'm not with that. It was always they're in the ring and you showcase the guys. So anyway, that's my personal take on it. Let's see what Pettis. You can see. Yeah, he's sticking that jab in there. Oh, and then the left hook by Foss. Got him going that way. Yeah, he's working. He's working. Yeah, again, like Pettis in that worker-like mentality. He might not be landing with power, but he's getting those punches in there. Oh, and then
nice,
Foss,
nice body shots.
But then Pettis kind of stuck him to move him back a little bit. He wasn't just going to sit there and eat punches. So Foss has got him into the corner.
There you go.
Pettis moves away. Yeah, body shot. Foss is still working that body. Then Pettis comes with his own body shot right to the head. Another shot, another left hand by Foss to the body. He just missed the left hook there to Pettis' head. Up, and then see Pettis again, you know, with just those shots that.
There he goes again. He switches to southpaw.
Switches to southpaw. You can see the Dallas humidity is getting these guys because they've got a lot of sweat. When they're getting hit,
I feel like we've gone 4-6 to 6
No, we're not even swinging. We're not swinging or anything.
I'm so glad to wear a suit tonight.
Yeah, I know, right? I feel bad for some of the TDO guys.
I have no idea how some of these judges
are
wearing sports
coats. Yeah, they have coats, and they've got to be sweating.
They've got to be soaking wet.
Yeah. Oh, the head of the TDLR here tonight, he's wearing a suit and tie, and there's no way. I would be sweating like crazy. Yeah, and Foss is still working. I give it to him that. You see, like, his body shots are nice.
Nice shot.
It's gonna take a pretty solid punch to get Pettis on the ground. Either that or he just gets tired because it doesn't look like he's going to do it, you know, voluntarily.
Now, I'm okay with somebody getting dropped. But just go four rounds.
Yeah, just keep four rounds. Yeah, just keep it going. Take that, you know, the count.
The crowd,
you know,
going.
Get up on nine. Keep it moving. Well, and then exchanging big shots to the face.
Nice body shot.
Yeah, and Pettis was just kind of like a slapping right hand. Foss is working. He's working. Left. He got Pettis back into the corner. We're back on the ropes and out of the corner. He's back to the right hand.
Oh, nice
combination.
Yeah,
that's
there you go.
Punch. That's nice.
There you go.
That's nice. Those are things you work on in the gym. You're not going to just pick up not knowing anything about boxing.
Foss doesn't look like he has a worry in the world.
No, not at all. That's what I mean. I guess if you look at just like his expression is like, we're fine. Like, I'm not worried. But I think he needs to get a little bit worrying him because Pettis could steal these rounds. It's nice, more out of like work rate.
Nice left hook, nice uppercut.
Yep. These guys with that 10. Oh, and he's just missing with that left. Yeah. But again, Pettis, you never know. We don't know where the judges are at, but fourth round.
All right. Yeah, I said four's the magic number.
Four's the magic number.
Right.
Again, these are fan-friendly fights. All work. You don't see any lulls in action.
These are blue-collar local fighters that get in the ring and lay it all out on the line.
And there is a live look-in brought to you by Panasonic. There's Alex Dabowski getting ready for his fight. And we'll be seeing him soon defending that ABO title against Daryl Hayes.
It's almost like you never want to leave it in the judge's hands. I hate to say that.
You never do. Those 3 or 4 minutes are like the scariest part of boxing. Right. You never know who won when it goes to the decision.
I think I know that ring girl there.
Do you?
Yeah. She comes to my toy boxing gym.
Oh, okay. Okay, we'll see what these guys have.
Final round. Round 4.
Michael, you got what you wanted. Let's see what they bring on this fourth round.
Again, I like maybe a knockdown. But yeah. Let's keep it at 4.
Get people riled up. Get that loud roar.
There you
right?
go.
Yeah, well, see, Pettis is not going anywhere. So, yeah, if I was Foss, I would just make sure.
These guys are soaking wet.
Yeah, soaking. I know. They're just soaking wet.
Every punch
is just water flying, like, all over. And us being so close, hopefully Foss doesn't get Pettis over here on the ropes near us because we might get drenched in sweat. I think Alad Martinez, the judge on
TDLR.
The other side, yeah, he's getting a nice bath in sweat because they keep on getting to that corner.
Nice right.
Nice.
Overhand just, hook,
yeah,
right.
It just depends on what these judges are.
Oh, there's a jab there.
That was a good shot. That was a good jab.
Woke him up.
He even kind of moved his jaw a little
bit. These guys are slugging it out.
Yeah.
And the ultimate professionals, they're keeping their mouthpieces in.
Yeah, exactly. Because we've had a few, I think it was like 3 or 4 mouthpieces hit the
left hook. The
canvas.
Another left hook. Oh.
Yeah, Pettis is not going anywhere. Yeah. Foss is going to have to take this round and pray that he got another one. Or otherwise, we could have one of those draws that we were talking about.
Right.
So.
It's a tough kid.
This could be 2-2. This could go 3-1 Pettis. You know, we'll see what Foss has to offer here. Again, he doesn't even
nice
look
right
tired. He looks like he's not breathing hard. Pettis looks like he's grinding and having to throw everything he has and use all the energy he has in these punches, but he's not stopping. He's still throwing punches. He's putting his hands down. Yeah, but now Foss is throwing punches. But again, Pettis is standing right in front of him.
Oh.
We'll see. I think fatigue is setting in for both guys at this point. There he goes. Southpaw again. Yeah, like trying to cut off the ring, which he's done very well. I just think Pettis steals these rounds. It looks like he's stealing them.
They're slugging it out.
Great, yeah. Yep, and then that left. They might not be like big shots, but they're actually hidden Foss, and you know, judges see that.
They're earning their paycheck, baby. That's for sure.
Definitely.
Both of them.
And the fans are enjoying it as well.
There you go. There's a little combination. There you go.
Yep. We'll see what happens when that 10-second bell. There it is.
There
you
it
got
is.
10 seconds. Let's see, what these, let's see if they open
seconds.
It up.
Let's see if they
see if they open it up. Again, this bet is right there, working. I'm not sure if Foss got that round. We'll see. We'll see what the scorecards show. Very easily the worker, the grinder could have taken that, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. I think with Foss, he looked good. He didn't ever look tired, but that work rate wasn't there as far as, like, Pettis just kept punching.
I think on his, I may be incorrect, but on his overall record, he doesn't have a lot of knockouts. So he may not have a lot of power. But,
But
you know what? He's a local favorite. He puts on a show. He comes to fight.
Yep.
What more can you ask for?
No, that's exactly.
Yeah, there's guys out there with better talent, bigger talent, faster, stronger.
But when you have a guy that's going to come in, he's going to fight 4 rounds, he's going to go the 8 rounds, he's going to be 10 rounds in front of you. He might lose, but you know, he's going to be there.
He's the guy that comes to work every day.
Yeah, exactly. And I, I think this fight definitely is. Pettis was definitely that guy. He was the grinder.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause to both fighters. Big round of applause. We have a unanimous decision. Judges Aladin Martinez and Richard Lord score the bout 39-37. Judge Robert Chapa scores the bout 40-36. Your winner by unanimous decision, Christian Fawz. Fawz.
I'm not sure.
You know, I would have called it a 3-1.
Yeah.
Maybe even.
Yeah, I thought Pettis was more of the worker bee, to be honest. But again,
that's why
we're broadcasting.
Good fight.
We're the judges. It was a great fight. It was a great fight.
So Christian Fawz successfully defends his title tonight in a solid performance against the veteran Guadalupe Perez. It'll be interesting to see where Fawz goes from here, but I'm sure it'll be exciting to watch, and hopefully we'll have it right here on 12 Rounds TV. Well, we'll be right back with our main event, the ABO lightweight title fight between current champion Alex Del Bosque and the always tough Daryl Hayes. Don't go anywhere.